this is arguably the most famous prison in the world, and now you're in it. Just the space, you know, the physicality of it, because it's quite claustrophobic. But modern day prisons are designed, they really consider not intimidating people or making spaces, you know, as loose strapped or popular. Outside didn't suffer from those restrictions. They did the research, they went out, studied Alcatraz, not just from books or internet. They were actually there to feel the environment, so it really sets a mood that gets you a little spooky. Well, we kind of started with the base layout of Alcatraz. The entire island we ended up roughing out in kind of a white box form, and then figuring out what play spaces we want to use that at, what would be the most interesting areas to play, and the connections between spaces, and spaces that the public doesn't necessarily get to go into. We really did a lot of pushing to really enhance that psychological horror aspect that we're really looking for. And this was a really good opportunity to really tell something special. I just got stuck right through the gates to hell! This time around, I feel like it's been identified that there are these side missions that you're going to go out and try to accomplish. Hal and the rest of the groups put together this escape plan. But the point is to get the parts and assemble this plane so they can get off the island. We did something new for the first time. We had actually contextual music to go with that. As a first example, it's all based around this horror film aspect. Every location will have a specific stinger that you hear when you find it and discover it, and you start unraveling the story, you start building on the music that you're hearing, and it's really enhancing that experience and going along with it in parallel. Because we wanted to embrace this kind of horror thriller, we wanted character actors, guys who could really embody someone and then convey emotion. So that's why we went for guys like really getting in that kind of guy, you know, we wanted a frantic nature, so he plays a character called Billy Hanson, who's this kind of psychopath who would be employed by the mob to kill people in interesting ways. Chance Palmentary, he plays a guy called Sal the Lucas, an old mob boss. Michael Madsen playing Finn O'Leary. He's kind of worked himself from the floor, you know, from the streets. He's got his hands dirty and he's worked in the guts a couple of times. And then we had Joe Pantolano, and he plays Arthur Arlington, who's nicknamed the Weasel. Those guys, they bring a quality and a subtlety and a timing that you can't really identify or try to recreate. Start off in the afterlife mode, and that's just going to be, you know, what's going on. You're going to try to solve the mystery from the second you start. Afterlife, to me, brings a new element, like a new puzzle element. It forces me to think a little bit more, but look for the clues, or kind of think of zombies on a slightly deeper level. You see clues throughout the map that tell you, ooh, perhaps if I'm in the afterlife, I can interact with this object, or there's some puzzle going on here that I need to be in the afterlife.
That easy. I wiped a dirty dentist with one of these. It took forever.
Alcatraz has a Civil War kind of fort background before it turned into a penitentiary. And so we had this kind of backstory, the idea of a warden that would have collected Civil War weapons. One of them is a blunderbuss. It's a fictional weapon, but the idea of the combination between a blunderbuss and a Gatling gun. And possibly, there might be a way of upgrading it to a more fantastical weapon that the players may find. There's one main zombie, one big zombie that's going to come through and wreak havoc on your life. He'll lock down the purge machine and close down the box, so you have to pay to get that open again. So you don't want him to interfere with your process.
Now's a good time to pick a fight.
It's a fun challenge. It keeps things moving forward. In terms of perks, we have a new perk called Electric Cherry. When you reload, it gives a shock around you. We scale it all the time.
Who's asking for it, Switch Ball?
There's so much to experience in this map. Every time I play it, there's a new tactic to take, a new experience, a new objective to go for. But there's also this layer of things that we aren't exactly exposing to the players right off the bat, and will need to be discovered.
We've got the undead in there, we've got these historical elements, and these fantastic actors all seem to be at peace with each other in this kind of same world. So it's magical. Our team was incredibly excited.